अस्मदाचारी पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माण विदाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तरुणहदेव आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेश नमो मह्यम सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे रूपेत्ते पारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वमिति मे निश्चिता मतिः। It should be visible now.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so continuing in the fourth chapter, we saw that the Jiva or the Chidabhasa Amsha goes through these three stages. So there are goes through seven stages. Ajnanam, Avaranam, Bhranti, meaning Vikshepa, Paroksha Jnana, Aparoksha Jnana, Shokanasha, which is also called as Anarthanivritti or Atyantika Dukhanivritti, then Atiharsha, which is Niratishyananda Prapti or Nityananda Prapti, which is Swarupananda. So these are the states, so to say, of Chidabhasa, who is Baddha, who gets Mukti, and for whom, to answer the question that Tattva Drishti has raised, is the Jnana. Jnanotpatti. Jnana kasya. Jnanam kasya bhavati was the question Tattva Drishti had asked here. Aham Brahma iti jnanam kasya iti vicharaha. There the answer is the abhasasya. Abhasasya eva and abhasasya saptavastas in the context are being dealt with. There we have looked at the ajnana and avarana swarupa. What is the lakshana of ajnana avarana? Ajnana and avarana, which are the first two. The third is bhranti or vikshepa. We have seen anayoho shaktyoho, which is aham na, aham, not aham, brahmanasti and brahmana bhati. These two are the results of avarna itself. Therefore, they are two shaktis, which are asatva apadika and abhana apadika. Both put together are called as sadharanataya, sadharanabhidha, avarnamiti. Tayoho, anayoho, nama. Then bhranti swarupa, bhranti swarupam, kutaste bhasamana janmadi samsaro vede bhranti rityuchyate. What is bhranti? This samsara, which is felt in kutastha chaitanya. Kutastha is pratyagatma, aham. I have samsara. So in me there is samsara, which is where the questioning started. Tattva Drishti had asked, why is there samsara in me if you say that I am already free? He said, there is no samsara in you. The Guru had told him, there is no samsara in you. Where from will you have dukkha in you? There is nothing called as samsara in you. And thereby there can't be any dukkha in you. Your Swarupa is Ananda Swarupa, to which the Tattva Drishti's question was, if it is so, why is there a pratiti of samsara in me and why is there a dukkha pratiti in me, not elsewhere? Siddha. Therefore, kutaste bhasamana janmadi samsara. Just give me a moment. My screen seems to have suddenly started flickering. Okay, I'll just take it up. Yeah. The screen should be a little smaller today because my second screen isn't working. So, kutaste bhasamana janmadi samsara vede bhrantir ityuchyate. That pratiti of samsara and samsara dukkha, which is due to janma ityadi. Janma, janmadi shadivikara. Janma and marana are the end vikaras at both ends. The other four are in between. So, dukkha, which is janma is also dukkha rupa, marana is also dukkha rupa, and all the way dukkha rupa, all the vikaras will also lead to finally dukkha. Some sukha, but then dukkha. That pratiti of pratiti is bhasama, janmadi samsara, which is appearing or seen or felt in oneself, that is called as bhranti in Veda. Ayameva samsara shoka shabdena apyuchyate. Same samsara is also called as shokaha. As long as there is samsara, one cannot avoid shoka. There is Shruti Pramana for that. Tatra ko muhaka shoka ekatvam anupashyataha is the Isha mantra. Tatra jnanavasthaya mokshavasthaya ko mohaha. Jnanavastha or mokshavastha is not a fourth avastha per se. Turiya is not a state per se. You've seen it is the real swarupa of Atma, which pervades in the other three states. Even in the Baddhavastha, Ajnanavastha also, that reality, Swarupa continues. What continues is Swarupa rather. Therefore, Tatra also means Tasmin Atmani. Tatra Brahmatmani, Kaha Mohaha, Kaha Shokaha. What kind of Moha is possible there? What kind of grief? Here, Samsara, really Shoka is possible. Ekattva manupashyataha, where one sees only one. Sees in is figurative. There is no seeing. One does not see anything or anyone else. That is ekattva manupashyan. That person is ekattva manupashyan, seeing. Tarati shokam atmavit, says the Chandogya Saptama Adhyaya. Narada Muni says that atmajnana lacking, I do not find any of the jnanas, which is in abundance. There is hardly anything which I do not know. But still, atma jnana lacking, I grieve. And I have heard tarati shokam atmavit. Once one gets atma jnana, becomes an atmavit, atmanam vetti iti atmavit, then saha atmavit shokam tarati. He crosses over samsara. That is the meaning. He crosses over grief. Then Mundaka Mantra we have seen earlier. Vidyate hrithay granthis chidyante sarva samshayaha. Shiyante chasya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. Mattav parataram nanyat kinjirasti dharanjaya. Na kartrutta na karmani lokasya srijati prabhu. Ajnane navrutam jnanam tena muyyanti jantava. Vasudeva sarvamiti samhatma sudurlabha. Ityadi shruti smriti bhi. Samsarasya atmaikatva jnanamatra nivartyatva bodhika. Bodhikabhihi brahmamatratvam bodhitam. Okay, I read this much and I realized that we did this in the end. I did it a little fast towards the end of the class. But I have explained most of this. There is no kartrutva karma for anyone that Prabhu gives. It is only due to bhranti. And other than myself, which is Atma, there is nothing else. And once one sees the para and avara, saguna and nirguna and saguna swarupa of brahmatma, then hridaya granthi goes away, which is avidya granthi, which causes this bhranti. And thereby sarva samshayaha, which are bhranti, they go away. Once the bhranti goes away, then there is no reason for anyone to continue doing karma. Kartrutva bhoktrutva bhranti goes away, then why would anyone be a karta bhokta? Therefore, all the karmas do not affect even the agami karmas, do not affect the person. Prarabdha continues to be there. Sanchita and agami are, there is a sanchita and agami karma kshaya, kshiyante chasya karmani. And the bhranti is also explained by moha shabda. So muhyanti jantaha muhyanti ajnanena. Ajnanena avrutam jnanam. Jnana, one's own swarupa jnana is covered by jnana. Therefore, tena karanena, tena hetuna jantavaha muhyanti. Everyone has moha, continues to be deluded. And when a person, kashchidhira, gets this jnana as Vasudeva Sarvam, Ishvara is manifest in the form of everything, including me, everything and everyone. That Mahatma is Sudurlabha. It is very difficult to see such jnana, such jnanis who have Sarvatma Bhava. Paroksha Aparoksha Jnana Swarupam. What is the Paroksha Jnana and Aparoksha Jnana which the Chidavasa has, Jiva has? Before that, here Dehendriya Prano Manahankara Adi Nam Janmadi Tadvikaranam Chatmani Pratyak Chaitanya Bhanam Atmanaha Tadharmanam Satya Jnana Anantanandadi Nam Cha Atmani Bhanam Cha Adhyasa Ityuchyate. What is Adhyasa? And here Janmadi, Janmadi Vikaras were seen. The Janmadi Vikaras, Adhyasa has gone up earlier, I think. Anyway, so Adhyasa, what is Adhyasa? Dehendriya, Pranam, Mana, Ahankara, and any other kosha that we can bring in. Wherever there is Tadatmya Sambandha identification and Janmadi Tadvikaranam Cha Atmani Pratyak Chaitanya Kutaste, in my real self, all these appear to be koshas as well as, you know, Janma and their Vikaras, Janmadi, all these Vikaras, Dehendri Vikara, Prana Vikara, Mana Vikara, Mano Vikara, Ahankara Vikara, Buddhi Vikara, all the Vikaras keep on continuing. And we see all those happening in Atma, unfortunately, in Pratyak Chaitanya, that Bhana, and Atmana Taddharmana, Satya Jnananta Anandadinam Cha Atmani Bhanam. Adhyasa Ityuchyate. So, in Anatma, so anatmani bhanam. In anatma, you have satya jnana ananta ityadi vichardi atma lakshana, so-called attributes, they appear to be in anatma, the dehendriya prana mano buddhi ityadi, whereas their janmadi tadvikara, all these appear to be in atma. Atma seems to be changing in keeping with the deha indriya ityadi, and dehendriya prana mana ityadi, all these appear to be alive and sentient. We are very happy with them. All these are adhyasta from Atma to Anatma. So there is a two-way superimposition. Both ways. It is not one way. Atma's so-called attributes are superimposed on Anatma, and Anatma's attributes are superimposed on Atma. This twofold superimposition is called as adhyasa. Asseva bhranti vikshepa shoka ityadi vyapadesha. These are the words used for adhyasa. Adhyasa, bhranti, vikshepa, shoka, all these are synonyms. Deshakala vastuvihi yasya antaha na bhavati paricheda na bhavati. So desha, kala and vastu paricheda aren't there, due to which there is no paricheda, due to this desha, kala or vastu. Kintu sarva desha, sarva kala, sarva vastu shucha vyapya yad vartate tad anantam vibhu bhuma iti cha uchyate. That which cannot be segmented in place, time or by any object, which pervades एवरी ऑब्जेक्ट एग्जिस्ट परवेडिंग ऑल ऑब्जेक्ट्स दैट इज कॉल्ड एज अनंत, पूर्ण, विभू, भूमा, ऑल दीज आर दी वर्ड्स विच आर सिनोनिम्स टू एक्सप्लेन दिस विच कैनॉट बी लिमिटेड एट ऑल इन एनी विच वे. अत्र अनंतम ब्रह्म इत्युक्त्या आनंद रूपम ब्रह्म इति अर्थात सिद्ध्यति. So some people have an allergy to the word ananda, especially because it is manifest in samadhi as per the shastra. Completely manifest. Of course, in Sushupti it is there, but in Sushupti we have to recall the Sushupti ananda in waking, because in Sushupti avastha there is ajnana continuing in its full manifestation, full bloomed form. That is why we experience nothing other than one's own ananda, which is recalled later. There is nothing else, no vikshepa is experienced, but avarana is experienced in sushupti. This avarana is not there in samadhi. So samadhi is useful if one has a doubt as to one's own ananda swarupa. Otherwise it may not be needed. But some people have allergy towards samadhi word itself. How can you compare Vedanta to yoga? These are the questions. These are the, how can you bring down Vedanta to the level of yoga samadhi? We are not bringing down anything to any level. Vedanta, jnanena moksha is true. But then, if one has doubts as to the ananda swarupa, which is the pursuit, which is keeping one engaged in each and every activity. Behind each and every activity, if you inquire into it, there is search for ananda. This cannot be discounted. At the root of each and every prani's action is, even this most selfless action also has one's own ananda being sought after. Ananda being sought after, which one does not know is one's own swarupa. Therefore, if a person has a question as to how can I understand my ananda swarupa, I don't think I am ananda swarupa. For such a person, there may be necessity of samadhi anubhava. Maybe. Which may resolve a doubt, because there is no avarana per se on one's own swarupa ananda. Swarupa ananda avarana goes away in samadhi. We don't say the ajnana completely goes away by samadhi. It will not go away. Jnaneneva moksha. But during the samadhi avastha, atma is spashta, swarupa is spashta. Thereby, ananda is the real goal. That is why moksha swarupa we have seen atyanta dukkha nivrutti and ananda prapti, paramananda prapti, which should be nitya, not in samadhi like anitya. Because once one comes out of samadhi, dukkha comes back again, because ananda is lost. One again starts hankering after things which are there. Raga dvesha manifest again. Apurnata continues. One remains antavan in buddhi. One remains antavan in buddhi, in moha. Thereby the seeking for ananda continues. Seeking for ananta, anantyam continues. So, ragadvesha, which are manifested forms of vasanas, they come back. Therefore, samadhi, another use of samadhi, even after jnanotpatti, even after one says, I am a jnani, but then prarabdha affects me so much that I am continuously having dukkha. Of course, one understands that it is at the level of the mind, but still there is dukkha continuing, which I do not want to continue. It is there in prarabdha, so one has to use free will to oppose that. Not to want anything, but to take away that also one is not interested in continuing in among people. Then one can withdraw and practice samadhi yoga, which is even after jnanotpatti, it is not for moksha, mind you. Nobody says that samadhi practice is for moksha, but it is to remove the obstacles which are not allowing person to have the ananda swarupa anubhava. which one may want. If one does not want, one is okay with the sharira and the sukshma sharira and the stura sharira dukkha rupa, which manifests in the antakarana, it is okay. But some may do want to stay away because prarabdha is cannot be cannot be predicted as to what kind of prarabdha is there. So there are multiple reasons. Even Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that one should take to sannyasa. And sannyasa does not mean, dance around with people. You have to withdraw from this. Sannyasa is nyasa. Nyasa cannot have, you cannot say that I'll be in the society through and through the way I was there earlier, live the same life, and I'll just change the ashrama. That is just change of vesha. It is not sannyasa. Because there is no nyasa. Samyak nyasa. That too not nyasa. Samyak nyasa. It is not only cognitive. The sannyasa, when Shastra talks about it, it is literal. It is ashrama change. And the ashrama change is vidhi purvaka, with the homa ityadi. It should be all systematically. It cannot be just manasika sannyasa, antara sannyasa can be there in any ashrama. But then to practice the vasana kshaya, one may have to withdraw. Anyway, that is a background. Why it is needed is because ananta shabda. When we say Sachidananda Brahma, this ananda, the shruti may not be directly available now. Sachidananda Brahma, that is a lakshana vakya. Where it is seen, currently it is not available. Some may think that it is not a shruti, but it is a shruti, ananda. How do you land on ananda even without the shruti is shown here. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. What is ananta? Ananta, when one seeks anantyam, nobody wants ananta life if it is the same life. One may think that I want to live forever, but ask the person who has dukkha, who has roga ityadi. Do you want to continue forever with this roga? There will be hardly a person who will say, yes, I do want to continue. Some on the deathbed with so much of pain may ask, ask person who is undergoing the pain of the of cancer, etc. Say, pull the plug on me. Don't put me on ventilator. All these because there is a lot of dukkha. Nobody wants anantyam for the sake of anantyam. That is the idea. Sachidananda is the goal to reach, to know one's own swarupa. Not satyam jnanam anantam. Ananta padena kim uchyate. Atra anantam brahma ityuktya anandarupam brahma ityarthat siddhyati. Ananda is the real goal. There is in the phala also, which was at jnana phalam kim, which was seen in the first chapter, it is atyantika dukkha nivritti. And then not anantya prapti, ananda prapti, paramananda prapti. That is the goal, therefore, arthat siddhyati. When you say ananta brahma, then ananda rupa brahma. How so? Ayameva artha chandogya saptama adhyaya naradaya sanat kumarena upadishtaha. In the seventh chapter of Chandogya Upanishad, Sanat Kumara explains this to Narada, because Narada's question is what we have seen here. Tarati shokam atmavit, I have heard. Tarati shokam atmavit, not that he says that someone gets it, I am okay with it. He wants that. He wants that shoka taranam, meaning ananda prapti. Atyante dukkha nivritti, whereby swarupa ananda shines forth. Yo vai bhuma tat sukam nalpe sukam asti, bhuma iva sukam, bhuma tveva vijidnyasitavya iti, bhumanam bhago vijidnyase iti. So yo vai bhumaha, yaha bhuma, that which is bhuma is, bhuman means ananta. Therefore, yo vai bhuma, indeed that which is bhuma, that which is purna, that alone is sukham, tat sukham. Vai means eva. Tadeva sukham, bhuma eva sukham. Alpe sukham nasti. There is no sukha in alpatva. Therefore, sukha is being sought, that will be known by anantya pada. Anantam brahma means ananda rupa, because sukha rupa. Bhuma eva sukham. Anantyam eva anandam. दट इज द ऐडिया देर भूमात्वेव विजिज्ञासितव्य इति वन शुड इंक्वायर इन टू द आनंत्यम वंस यू इंक्वायर इन टू आनंत्यम यू लैंड ऑन आनंद भूमानं भगवः भगवः इज हे भगवान छांदस प्रयोग सूत्र सिद्ध ऑफ कोर्स भूमानं विजिज्ञासे सो आई वांट टू नो दिस भूमन टू लैंड ऑन सुख दैट इज द आइडिया यत्र नान्यत् पश्यति नान्यत् शृणोति नान्यत् विजानाति स भूमा एंड व्हाट इज दिस भूमा इफ यू इंक्वायर इनटू विजिज्ञास ज्ञासितव्यः देन यत्र अन्यत् न पश्यति अन्यत् न शृणोति अन्यत् न विजानाति स भूमा दैट रियालिटी विच इज सो कॉल्ड स्टेट ऑफ मोक्ष इज भूमा अथ यत्र अन्यत् पश्यति अन्यत् शृणोति अन्यत् विजानाति तदल्पम् देयर बाय इफ वन सीज समथिंग एल्स वन हियर समथिंग एल्स वन नोस समथिंग एल्स देन देयर इज अ सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन एंड देयर बाय इट इज अल्प यो वै भूमा तदमृतम् अथ यद अल्पम् तन्मर्त्यम् वॉट इज भूम अनंत इज अमृत इमोर्टैलिटी एंड इमोर्टैलिटी नॉट विद दुख बिकॉज भूम इज अमृत ऑल्सो यो वै भूम तत्सुखम देयरफॉर सुख इज ऑल्सो देयर अथ यद अल्पम तन्मर्त्यम एंड वॉट इज अल्प इज मर्त्य mortal anything little is mortal because it will come to an end sa eva adastas uparishtat sapaschas purastas dakshinatah sa uttaratah sa eva idagum sarvam iti and then the same chandogya adhyaya also says the same bhuma brahma tattva is everywhere in all directions are listed there atrayo सॉरी अत्र यः अनंतरूपः भवति स भूमा भवति यः भूमा स आनंदरूपः भवति इत्युक्तम् देयर बाय व्हाट शुड बी अंडरस्टूड इज वेयर अनंत इज मेंशन्ड दैट ब्रह्म इज अनंत दैट ब्रह्म इज मी देयरफॉर यः अहम् अनंतरूपः भवामि आई एम भूमा आई एम अनंत्य एंड देयरफॉर आई मीन आई एम अनंत आई हैव अनंत्यम therefore bhuma is ananda roopa I am ananda roopa you have to convert this prathama purusha into one's own first person atascha anantatvad eva brahmana ananda roopatva api siddham so when we see satyam jnanam anantam then it means sadeva satyam satya means satyam chit means सत्यम ज्ञानम सो ज्ञानम ज्ञानम मीन्स चित एंड आनंद अनंत मीन्स आनंद दैट इज सिद्ध नाउ लेट्स लुक एट परोक्ष अपरोक्ष ज्ञान स्वरूप ब्रह्म नास्ति इति असत्वापादक आवरणांशम अस्ति ब्रह्म इति वेदांत वाक्यजन्य परोक्ष ज्ञानम नाशयति परोक्ष ज्ञान इज What Brahma asti? You have seen this earlier. Paroksha jnana is Brahma asti. With the Prathama Purusha. And then Brahma aham asmi is Aparoksha jnana. So Paroksha jnana Brahma asti. When that takes place, then Brahma nasti iti asatva padaka avarana ausham nashayati. Asti Brahma, Brahma Asti, that will take away Brahma Nasti. It will counter, they are opposite to each other. When Brahma Asti becomes stronger, in knowledge is stronger, then it will take away Ajnana which opposes it. Therefore, Asatvapadaka Avaranausha, that Avaranausha of Ajnana which covers Brahma as not being there, that is removed by, destroyed by Vedanta Vakya. Paroksha jnana, therefore Vedanta Vakya Janya. Paroksha jnana will also come through Vedanta Vakya alone. It will not be so that Aparoksha jnana alone comes from Vedanta Vakya. Thereby, Paroksha jnana, which is Asti Brahma, will destroy brahmanasti, which is the avarana ansha asatvapadika. Then there is abhana apadaka avarana ansha. Brahma satya jnananta swarupam bhavati. Sorry, just give me a moment. Brahma satya jnananta swarupam bhavati iti jnanam paroksha jnanam ityuchyate. There is Brahma. What kind of Brahma is it? Satya jnananta swarupa. That is why in Taittiriya Upanishad, when the Lakshana Vakya is given, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, that is, if you add Asti there, which is the general case, unless the teaching of Aikya is given, there is no teaching of Aikya yet. So, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, when that Vakya comes up, it will generate Paroksha Jnana. Because general case Vyakrana says you add Asti there. Unless the Upanishad shows the Aikya by Panchakosha Viveka and then landing on the Swarupa. There Brahma Satya Jnana Ananta Swarupam Bhavati. You add Asti or Bhavati, it is Prathama Purusha. Thereby, iti jnanam paroksha jnanam ityuchyate. That is paroksha jnana, it will take away Brahma nasti. Because of Shruti being pramana, one having shraddha in the pramana, just like one has shraddha in the eyes that what I see in front of my eyes is real. That is the shraddha in the eyes, in the pramana, indriya pramana. Similarly, there is pramana of Shruti in which one has shraddha. Therefore, when Shruti says Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, and thereby we understand as Asti, we know that there is Brahma, and Brahma Nasti, misunderstanding will go away. Idancha Paroksha Jnanam Nasti Brahma Iti Pratiti Virodhi. It will oppose this Brahma Nasti Iti Pratiti. Natu Anyasya Kasichidapi Virodhi. It can't do anything more than that. If you say Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma Asti, then it cannot take away anything else. It cannot lead to moksha, moksha rupa jnana. It will lead to only jnana that Brahma isn't there is wrong. That misunderstanding. I had a misunderstanding that Brahma isn't there. There was no knowledge of Brahma at all. Thereby, if you don't know anything, really don't think about it. But if somebody asks you, do you know Brahma? I don't know what is Brahma. I don't know that there is something called as Brahma. That idea will go away. Aham Brahma iti dhridatara nirvichikitsa paroksha jnanantu. Meaning aparoksha jnanam. There is a savarna dirga sandhi. Dhridatara nirvichikitsa paroksha jnanantu. Sakalasya avidya tatkaryasya virodhi. However, aham brahma iti jnanam. Satyam jnanam anantam brahma aham asmi. Through the mahavakyas, any mahavakya. There are many mahavakyas in each and every Upanishad which show aikya between the tatpada and tvampada, Ishvara and Jiva. There aham brahma iti dhridatara nirvikitsa aparoksha jnanantu. Nirvichikitsa paroksha jnanantu dhridatara. There should be nishtha. It should be doubtless. That kind of jnana will be virodhi for entire avidya and avidya karya. Nothing will remain. Bhasmi karoti. Ata eva idam aparoksha jnanam aham brahma na veda iti ajnanam brahma nasti na bhati cha iti avarana dvayam naham brahma kintu punya papadi karta tatphalanam sukadukhanam bhokta cha jivaha iti bhrantim cha iti etavantam avidya samuham nasheti. What is this avidya and avidya karya? Sakala, complete avidya and avidya karya will be taken away by this aparoksha jnana as aham brahmasmi. This aparoksha jnana will deal with aham brahma na veda. I do not know brahma. That kind of ajnana it will counter. Then brahma nasti na bhati, which was the earlier two. Avarna, there are two avarna shaktis. One covers up and one covers up the swarupa of brahma, and the second shakti does not let it shine forth. So nasti and na bhati will both be countered by this aparoksha jnana, which will be countered by paroksha jnana also. Only brahma nasti, that part will be countered by paroksha jnana. However, aparoksha jnana, aham brahma, will counter both the avarana shaktis, and then aham brahma na veda, that kind of ajnana, I do not know brahma. Naham brahma kintu punya papadi karta. So kartrutva bhoktrutva also, tatphalanam sukadukkhanam bhokta. This kind of bhranti also, which is the resultant of avarana, I am a karta, I am a bhokta, both will be countered by aparoksha jnana. So entire avidya and avidya karya means all these. Bhranti nasha swarupam. So bhranti nasha, what is it exactly? Mayi janana maranadi bhava vikaro nasti, mayi sukadukkhadikam leshato api nasti. So there's a sparrow which keeps on, you know, making noise, so to say. Some students get disturbed. Someone told me that there's always, you know, you have hear something in the background. So I have to scare it away. Mai janana maranadi bhava vikaro nasti. In me there is no shadvikara. I undergo no vikara. I am avikari. This is the resultant of the bhranti nasha. Mai sukadukkhadikam leshato api nasti. There is not even a bit of sukadukkha in me. I am sada ananda swarupa. I cannot have gradations of sukha. I cannot have gradations of dukkha either. Samsara dharma gandho api mai nasti. In me there is no other samsara dharmas. Nothing in the samsara affects me at all. Not even a bit. Kintu aham janmadi vikara shunya kutastha eva asmi. I am kutastha chaitanya. I cannot have any of the vikaras. Iti evam atmani sarvanarthanam nishedha eva bhranti nasha swarupam iti avadhyayam. What should be understood is this. In atma, negating each and every vikara, anartha, each and every anartha. Every anartha that one associates with oneself, negating that is bhranti nasha. Atra cha kutasthe janma nisheda sarvanartha api nishiddaha eva bhavanti. Generally we say shadvikara, shadvikaras are not there. But if you refute the first vikara, janma nisheda if you do. Janma is not possible for atma, for me. I was never born. If that is a dhrida conclusion, then you don't need to refute anything else. That is why Mandukya takes to Ajatavada. I was never born. Ajata Brahma. This samsara cannot be there for me. I myself am not born. Where can there be samsara for me? Where can there be shadvikaras? No possibility of other vikaras exist if the first vikara itself is negated. It's a shortcut method. Instead of analyzing everything, you take the shortcut method. Occam's razor. Otherwise called, I think, law of parsimony. Laghavam is there in this. In Nyaya Shastra, this is called as Laghavam. There is Laghavam in this methodology, in Mandukya Prakriya, Ajatavada. Brahma, which is me, Pratyagatma, Kutastha Chaitanya. In me, there is no Janma. So, Janma Vikara refuted. Every other Vikara, Samsara, Dukkha is refuted. Janma Nishedhat Eva. सर्वानर्था अपि निषिद्धा एव भवन्ति, ऑल अदर्स आर रिफ्यूटेड बिकॉज आई हैव डिपेंडेंसी ऑन माय जन्म, ओनली इफ आई हैव जन्म देयर कैन बी अदर अदर थिंग्स पॉसिबल, जन्मानंतरा भावित्वाद इतरानर्थ व्रातानां, बिकॉज ऑल दी अदर अनर्थ व्राता आर आनंतर भावी, दे आर आफ्टर जन्म, जन्मानंतर भावी, विदाउट जन्म अदर विकार ऑब्वियसली नॉट पॉसिबल, इट इज सिंपल लॉजिक, आत्मनि जन्म निषेधात षडपि भाव विकाराः निषिद्धाः भवन्ति, ऑल दी अदर्स आर रिफ्यूटेड वेन जन्म इज रिफ्यूटेड फॉर आत्मा, अयमेव भ्रांतिनाश शोकनाश शब्देन अप्युच्यते, एंड देयर बाय भ्रांतिनाश विच इज रिफ्यूटेड बाय जन्म इट्सेल्फ, इन आत्मा देर इज नो जन्म, देर इज नो अदर भाव विकार पॉसिबल, देर बाय संसार इज नॉट पॉसिबल, देर बाय दुख इज नॉट पॉसिबल, संसार इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज शोक, देर फॉर संसार नाश एव शोकनाश, भ्रांतिनाश एव शोकनाश. What is Atiharsha, which is the last avastha? Atiharsha swarupa varnanam. He shishya, aham advitiya brahma eva asmi iti evam nirvichikitsam swatma swarupa sakshatkara rupam jnanai yada tava jayate tada tava niratishya anandanu bhavatyeva. Once you know that I am advitiya brahma, meaning there is no other Brahma, there is no other Abrahma, I don't have any Janma, there is nothing other than me, there is no one other than me, that kind of understanding, when it becomes Dhridha, Nirvichikitsam, completely Manana Siddha, when there is Nishtha in it, then Swatma Swarupa Sakshatkara Rupam Jnanam, that kind of Sakshatkara, which itself is Sakshatkara. There are no obstacles to Jnana. What kind of obstacles? It is impossible. Impossibility is one obstacle to Nishtha in Jnana. Or there is Shanka at times whether it is really possible. Sometimes Pramana related to Pramana, sometimes related to Prameya. Whether the Shruti is really saying that, because someone else brings up some other Shruti, Dvasuparna Ityadi, and then raises a doubt, we don't remember the teaching sometimes, then what will happen? It may create a doubt that, oh, there are some Shruti Vakyas which talk about Dvaita also, maybe they are also right. Pooja Swamiji used to say that, ye bhi chalta hai, wo bhi chalta hai. We used to joke about it. This is also right, that is also right. You know, you be inclusive. Why don't you be inclusive that, you know, you include everyone. Oh, you please include everyone in Vyavahara, in Dharma Karya, kindly include everyone. In Vaidika Karya, bring along everyone, let them get the phala, let them take to Dharma. But in your own Adhyatma Sadhana, you cannot say this is also right, that is also right. So, Vishishta Advaita is also right. Nayayikas are, oh, they are basing it on logic, they are right. If nothing else, science is right. But science does not have consciousness as its goal, because they will never reach. There should be no doubt at all. They will never reach the conclusion. Why so? Because one who is inquiring into everything else will definitely miss himself. The subject is part of the experiment, and they do not want the subject to be the part of the experiment, because the entire objectified world is the goal in analysis. In analyzing that, the subject, unfortunately, even if they do not want, is influencing their results. The object which is being observed changes, the observation is changing by the mere presence of the subject. Who is the real goal? They do not know that. They never have the goal as consciousness. They think consciousness is a result of chemical reactions or object interaction with another object. Subject is never being inquired into. So if that is not the goal, why even compare? Now I bring this out because I know someone who inquired into all this and thought that this is also right, that is also right, and we think that because we are trained, oh, I am a scientific person, how can I agree with all this? You remain a scientific person in the worldly, not in the spiritual pursuit, because spiritual pursuit, Atma, has nothing to do with science. Science has nothing to do with Atma. They are not even inquiring into Atma really. Even the psychological fields are inquiring only into Manas. This psychology thing is not going to work in Adhyatma. Stick to Shastras. Shastras' ways of dealing with the mind are different. They are not psychological solutions. The way the modern science talks about it. There are solutions. Because all mental, good or bad, mental well-being is needed in for Jnana also and for Jnani also. For the welfare of the society. Because if the Jnani is continuing to stay in society, he cannot take the Advaita perspective and interact with the world. Interaction needs Dvaita. Thereby, sanity is called for. See, Unmattavat won't work there. Unmattavat should retire from society. And will retire from society. Or does not care about the society. He does not go on teaching. Do this, do that. And nobody should take that teaching also, even if that person is a Jnani. Because he has nothing to teach you, he has no methodology. He is completely out there, you know, he is completely absorbed. He does not even know how the Sharira goes. It goes on its own due to Prarabdha. Extreme case. But otherwise, there is a methodology to deal with, which is yogic. Yoga is a methodology which deals with or punah punah shravanam. Continuing with the Shravana, Shravana Mana Nididhyasana, or the way Navadha Bhakti is talked about, same Navadha Bhakti in Atma and the Shruti, Advaita Upanishad, Advaita Shastras, that Navadha Bhakti and dealing with, you know, talking about Atma Tattva, discussing it, being committed to it, doing Atma Puja, Puja Iva Puja. Teaching it, telling others, all this is also part of, you know, Navadha Bhakti converted unto Atma Bhakti. That also is another way of Nididhyasana, continuing with that. Thereby, all these are possible ways in Atma Jnana. And after Atma Jnana, they can continue. So I took a detour from this. Advaita Brahma Eva Asmi Swatma Swarupa Sakshatkara Rupam Jnanam Iti Yan Jnanam Yada Tava Jayate. And this should definitely be at the cost of every other philosophical perspective being right. It should be at their cost. You cannot say that others are also right. That is where I took a detour to explain that, be it science also, we should be very clear what the Shastra is talking about, and there can be obstacle in the form of no, Shastra isn't talking about that. Then Prameya Samshaya can be, is the Shastra talking about me or someone else? It can be someone else who has done more sadhana, who is more qualified. I may need many janmas, whatever it is, or at least one more janma. All this is also going to place an obstacle. I need to do something else other than this. Okay, Jnana is there, but Anubhava is lacking. This is the most common problem. Jnana is there, but Anubhava isn't there. This is because Brahma Asti, Aham Brahma Asmi is lost on the person. Otherwise, that Aparoksha Jnana itself is Aparoksha Anubhava. Terminologies are understood through translations. Somebody studies Western philosophy, Western psychology, or something else, some other language where experience is used for subject-object division. Experience of the object by the subject is what is called as an experience. When an interaction is there between the subject and the object, that interaction leading to something, that is called as the object experience. So experience definitely means the object. But in Sanskrita, there is no difference between Jnana and Anubhava. We have seen this. स्मृति भिन्न ज्ञानम अनुभव नैयायिका से दैट एंड वी एग्री देर इज नो रीजन टू डाउट इट ज्ञान इज अनुभव अनुभव इज ज्ञान इफ वन सेज दैट आई हैव ज्ञान बट आई डोंट हैव आत्म अनुभव इज अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट हैव ज्ञान देर शुड बी नो डाउट दैट अ पर्सन हु सेज आई हैव ज्ञान बट डोंट हैव अनुभव डज नॉट हैव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान हैज परोक्ष ज्ञान फाइन There are a lot of obstacles. They are to be dealt with. They can be dealt with yogic process also, but it is not for moksha. It is for sthirata of jnana to remove the obstacles as jnana works. The reason jnana is not working is because it is kept paroksha. Doubts are lingering on. Therefore, here, which is completely inquired into that kind of jnana, swatma swarupa sakshatkara rupam jnana yada tava jayate tada tava niratishya anandanubhava bhavati eva. One cannot say there is no ananda anubhava. Jnanotpatyanantaram. Also, I have jnana, but I don't have sukha. Then the person needs a lot of effort on the other parts. Which are those other parts? That person has been a gate crasher. Most of us are gate crashers to the so-called Vedanta party. We are gate crashers. We do not have complete sadhana chatushte sampatti. Complete in the sense, a great measure. It complete may not be possible for anyone. But we have not put enough effort in dharma, karma yoga, to earn the viveka which is ever existent. Therefore, vairagya is lacking and it shows in our actions. We don't need to showcase others. We know ourselves whether our actions are clear to our own self, whether my action is leading to vairagya from the action. Whether my effort is leading to vairagya from the action or not, whether I am really indulging for the sake of the result or I am doing it without the phalechha, that will show my tendencies, will show my vasanas which are manifesting. Thereby, viveka vairagya and especially Shamadama ityadi shatka which is there. Shamadama ityadi, all those in which uparati is very important. After jnanotpatti, uparati should be understood as sannyasa. At least in the sense of withdrawing from everything other than that which will make me stay in the jnana that I have already attained. Everything else is taking me away. So, jnana rakshana is also needed. Jnana rakshana is possible only if one does not indulge in anything else. Whether one can do it is questionable, but whether one takes efforts towards that goal, that will show up. That will show up not for others. One may showcase to others, but do I know that I am putting enough efforts towards that goal? Then only this ananda anubhava is possible. Otherwise, it is not possible. Therefore, swatma swarupa sakshatkara rupam jnana yadatava jayate tadatava niratishya anandanubhava bhavatyeva. And if one is not withdrawing from actions which lead to other goals, then all that it means is that swarupa sakshatkara is not there. And if that person thinks that I have jnana, then that is incorrect. Why? Because jnana says that there is nothing else. How can one have indulgence in something else? Indulging in something else is definitely preceded by an understanding that there is something else. And if that understanding precedes, then it is misunderstanding, it is not jnana. Therefore, one should inquire in each and every effort whether my phalechha is backing it at all. At least at the cognitive level, one should keep alert. And then this ananda anubhava is going to be definitely there. Bhavati eva, ayam eva maharsha iti uchyate. That is called as atiharsha or maharsha. On maharsha, there is a commentary there. Tippana there. Maharsha rupo ayam ananda panchadashyam trupti dipe vidyaranya munibihi nirankusha trupti iti vyapadishtaha. So Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya in panchadashi, Tripti Deepa would be the seventh chapter. In seventh chapter, he says, Nirankusha iti. तृप्ति इज निरंकुशा तृप्ति ही, आनंद इज महाहर्ष, दिस महाहर्ष इज महाहर्ष, सांकुशा सा अंकुशा, अंकुशा सह वर्तते सांकुशा, विषय ही तृप्तिर यम तृप्तिर निरंकुशा, सो दिस तृप्ति विच इज मोक्ष तृप्ति मुक्ति दैट इज निरंकुशा, वेर एज विषय आनंद इज सांकुशा। सर कि somebody is starting his vehicle, okay, so sankusha and nirankusha, the vishaya trupti is sankusha, whereas nirvishaya atma trupti is nirankusha, vishayanandastu satishayatvat uttarottara anandeccham janayati iti hetuho sankusha ityuchyate, why is vishaya vishaya trupti is tainted, is limited, why so, because it will keep a person yearning for more and more of such vishaya sukha, one will keep on looking for more and more of that particular vishaya sukha, which vishaya that particular vishaya which gave a person sukha, one will keep on looking for it again and again, iti hetu, therefore it is sankusha ityuchyate, आत्मानंदस्तु स्वस्माद् उत्कृष्टानंदाभावात् निरंकुशा भवति, देयर इज नथिंग नथिंग विच इज सुपीरियर टू आत्मानंद, इन विषय यू कैन हैव ग्रेडेशन, इन आत्मानंद यू कैन नॉट हैव ग्रेडेशन, सो विषय द सेम विषय व्हेन एक्सपीरियंस अगेन विल गिव लेसर आनंद, देयरफॉर वी नीड टू इंडल्ज मोर and more, or search for another vishaya which will lead to more sukha. Of course, all this is bhranti. Dashama purusha akhyayikayam dashamaha atmanam vihaya itaran navayeva purushan ganayan swasya dashamatvam na jananati iti yat tadeva ajnanam. Now, using the dashama purusha example very nicely, you know, dashama purusha example is absolutely wonderful. It shows what is aparoksha jnana. What is aparoksha jnana is clear in dashama purusha example and paroksha jnana also. So he takes that example, the Tippanakara Swamiji explains that. I'll just finish this last line before, so I'll have finished the page. Pradarshita saptamastaha chidabhasasya eva. All these seven avasthas which are shown here, ajnana ityadi, all those are chidabhasas, not kutasthas. अहम ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम पंचम्याम अवस्थायाम अंतर्गतम भवति, एंड व्हाट वाज शोन अर्लियर द क्वेश्चन वाज अहम ब्रह्म इति ज्ञानम कस्य भवति चिदाभासस्य एव भवति, एंड इन द सेवन अवस्थास वेयर इज इट, इट इज इन द फिफ्थ अवस्था व्हिच इज द अपरोक्ष ज्ञान, अपरोक्ष ज्ञान, एंड देन वी हैव दुख निवृत्ति इत्यादि शोकनाश एंड Atiharsha. These are the sixth and seventh stage, but fifth stage is the aparoksha jnana, which is what? Aham brahma iti jnanam panchamyam avasthayam antargatam bhavati. Panchamyam avasthayam kasya chidabhasasya. So dashama purusha example, I'll stop after this. Dashama purusha akhyayika, what is it? We know this 10th man story, ten went out for a picnic, kind of a picnic spot. They crossed a river or something, and then after crossing over, the leader counted 9. He left out himself, and then after many counts also, one could not count 10, and thereby they thought that the 10th is drowned in the river and started crying. There is dukkha, which is real. The dukkha is real. In vyavahara, dukkha is real. Crying is real, thinking that the person is gone is real, and that example is shown here. A passerby looks at them, asks, why are you crying? And then he knows, he says that there is a 10th. He makes them stand in a queue, count 9, the leader counts 9, and then he says, you are the 10th. That is aparoksha jnana. There. So that example is used here. Dashama purusha akhyayikayam दशम आत्मान विहाय इतरान नवैव पुरुषान गणयन स्वस्य दशमत्वं न जानाति इति यत् तदेव अज्ञानम्. नॉट नोइंग दैट आई एम द 10, द लीडर हु इज काउंटिंग काउंट्स 9, डिस्काउंटिंग हिमसेल्फ ही काउंट्स द अदर 9, एंड देन दैट आई डू नॉट नो द 10th. There is no 10 because there is no 10. That is ajnana. Dashamattvam na janati swasya. Does not know that he himself is the 10th. That is ajnana. Dashamo nasti na bhati iti etat avarnam. The first stage is what? Chidabhasa avastha. For the leader, from the perspective of the leader of the group, dashamaha nasti na bhati. There is no 10th and I can't see the 10th. The 10th is not revealing himself. Therefore, the 10th isn't there and is not shining forth, is not seen. Etad avarnam, that is avarna. Dashama mamara. Dashamo mamareti kalpayitva rodanam shokaha. For Vyakrana students, anyway, somebody who is studying Vyakrana or studied Vyakrana, there may be many out of you. You can think about mamara. Mamara is a litlakara, right? So why litlakara has been used here? One can think, dashamo mamara iti kalpayitva rodanam shokaha. Is dead. Litlakara is used here. Dashamaha mamara, the 10th is dead. Past tense of course, but why litlakara? There are three past tenses. Why not lung? Why not lung? Why litlakara? Very interesting usage. दशमो ममारेति कल्पयित्वा रोदनम शोकः. The grief is seen in one's own mental state. Oh, there is dukkha. One may show in crying also. So that is with an imagination that the 10th is dead. That is shoka. अयमेव भ्रांतिः विक्षेप इति च कथ्यते. And that is the second says, bhranti, vikshepa or shoka. Dashamo namrutaha, jivati saha. The passerby says that, no, 10th isn't dead. Why are you crying? The 10th isn't dead. He is alive. Meaning, there is a 10th. He is alive. That is paroksha jnana. Iti aptoktya. The passerby, he has no reason to lie. So you trust him. That is the aptavakya. That alone is pramana. Generally, unless there is a past where one has been cheated, one trusts others. That is our nature, you know. Somebody, you ask a direction for, you know, for some place. You ask someone, a passerby, a shopper, you know, a shopkeeper or a passerby. You just ask, where is this place? You accept, unless proven wrong, that the person is right. That is the Shraddha. And thereby, aptavakya, when someone says, oh, 10th is alive, then you take it as valid. Iti aptoktya dashama sattva vedanam paroksha jnanam. Knowing that there is the 10th is there. Like Brahma asti, that is paroksha jnana. Then, where is the 10th? Oh, is there a 10th? Where have you seen him? Where is him? Then the apta says, you are the 10th. Tameva dashamo si. Dashamastvamasi, when he says that, iti sakshad upadishtasan, being taught directly by the, you know, being told directly by the passerby or being taught directly by the guru. Who is passerby in your life? The guru is passing by. He tells you that you are Brahma. Tattvamasi. Punarapi ganana samaye swatmanam dashamatvena ganayitva. Then there is manana. Oh, really? I am the 10th. Then he counts the 9 and then counts himself. Swatmanam dashamatvena ganayitva. Having counted oneself as the 10th, atmanam dashamatvena janati iti yat tadeva aparoksha jnanam. Counting yourself. Oh, I am Brahma, Shruti. You inquire into what has been taught. Oh, really? Shruti is saying, I am Brahma. Then you look into the prakriya, use the methodology, do the panchakosha viveka or avasthatraya pariksha, land on your own self as being one with Brahma, with the jahadajal lakshana, and then that is aparoksha jnana. Idrishad aparoksha jnanad रोदन निवृत्तिरेव भ्रांति नाशः. व्हाट इज द रिजल्टेंट भ्रांति नाश? रोदन निवृत्ति शोक निवृत्ति. सो वन स्टॉप्स बीइंग अ वांटिंग पर्सन इन द एग्जेम्प्लीफाइड. आई डू नॉट क्रेव फॉर एनीथिंग. आई डू नॉट थिंक दैट समथिंग एल्स विल मेक मी पूर्ण. आई डू नॉट थिंक दैट देर इज समथिंग एल्स विच कैन मेक मी पूर्ण बिकॉज देर इज नथिंग एल्स. दैट इज भ्रांति नाश. स्वस्यैव दशमत्व ज्ञानात् जायमान संतोष अतिहर्षः. And definitely it will result in sukha. Not only dukkha nivritti but sukha prapti also, because we are all 10. There is no one who is drowned. Therefore sukha also will be there, atiharsha. If there is none other than me, I am purna, I am sat chit and ananda, I will never die, I can never die. I have nothing to do with the bodily issues, mental issues. I have nothing to do with the sharira issues. I am free from each and every sharira, each and every limitation that will lead to sukha. In the exemplified, asu avasthasu ajnanam avaranam vikshepa iti imas tisraha avasthaha bandhakaranani bhavanti. In the seven, the first three, ajnana, avarana, vikshepa, these three are bandhakaranas. Avasishtaha tu avasthaha चतस्रापि मोक्ष साधनानि भवन्ति. वाइल दी अदर फोर आर मोक्ष साधनास. विद दिस वील स्टॉप दी पार्ट. हम आई वेंट अ लिटिल अहेड, टुक अ लिटिल मोर टाइम. वील कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. हम सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूप अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे दृक्यत्व निर्गुण अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव हनुमत्व नित्यं मे निश्चिता मतिः. एनी क्वेश्चंस? Any, I have a question. I have already told you. Mamara, why Mamara Prayoga? Somebody who is interested in Vyakrana can think over. Okay, namaste.